Praise God. Hallelujah, Jesus. God is good all the time. We give Him the glory and the honor. All glory and honor belongs to Him. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Christ. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Another home taping. It is imperative that we as pastors throughout the world, if we cannot get to go to our church to have services, whether midweek and Sundays, then we can do in videos at home. I hope this video will be a blessing. Let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I thank you for this hour of prayer again. And I thank you for the privilege. Lord, we are living in a free country. God bless this country, United Kingdom. Also bless the rest of free countries and also those that are coming to this country that are not free to worship to Lord. Spread your wings over the world. Thank you for everything, O Lord. I pray in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We ask all these mercies and blessings in Jesus' precious holy name. Amen. Another day. Praise the Lord. And I must tell you, I must greet you in the mighty name of Jesus, but I must tell you that I will be coming from another of the major prophet, Daniel, an exological book, Daniel, and also Revelation. And I can add that all of the Bible, all of the books of the Bible, amen, they all speak of Christ. The first prophecy of Christ was Genesis 3, verse 15. The seed of the woman shall bruise and the head of the serpent, and the serpent shall bruise his heel. And notice the word seed. Amen. Women don't have seed. So that tells us that Christ would have born from a woman, but not from a earthly father. God bless you. I'll be playing this song, which is a beautiful song. I'm going to start off with this song, and I hope you all enjoy it. Hallelujah, Jesus. Praise God. Song is coming up. Amen. Hallelujah, Jesus. Team doesn't want to play, it seems to me, but I'm going to try my most best to play it. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Worthy is the Lamb. Amen. Jesus. Holy, for you, Lord God Almighty, worthy is the Lamb. Amen. Amen. Praise God. I will be dealing with Daniel chapter 2. And Daniel chapter 2 recorded the dream of Nebuchadnezzar in his second year of reign. And it read thus. And in the second year of the reign of Nebuchadnezzar, Nebuchadnezzar dreamed dreams, wherefore his spirit was troubled, and his sleep brake with him. It means that he got up and he was a bit maybe tormented because he had a dream and dreams and he didn't remember the dreams anyway. Then the king commanded to call the magicians and the astrologers and the sorcerers and the Chaldeans for to show the king his dreams. And so they came and stood before the king. And the king said unto them, I have dreamed a dream, and my spirit was troubled to know the dream. Then spake the Chaldeans to the king in Syriac, that's the language at the time in Babylon, O king, live forever. Tell thy servant the dream, and we will show the interpretations. The king answered and said to the Chaldeans, some people said Chaldeans, the thing is gone from me. If we will not make known unto me the dream with the interpretation thereof, ye shall be cut in pieces, and your houses shall be made a dunghill. A dunghill? Amen. But if ye show the dream and the interpretation thereof, ye shall receive of me gifts and rewards and great honor. Therefore show me the dream and the interpretation thereof. Hallelujah, Jesus. They answered and said, let the king tell his servants the dream, and will show the interpretation of it. The king answered and said, I know of a certainty that ye would gain the time, because ye see the thing is gone from me. But if you will not make known unto me the dream, there is but one decree for you, for ye have prepared lying and corruption words to speak before me till the time be changed. Therefore tell me the dream, and I will know that ye can show me the interpretation thereof. The Chaldeans answered before the king and said, there is not a man upon the earth that can show the king's matter. Therefore there is no king, lord, nor ruler that asks such things at any magician or astrologer or Chaldeans. And it is waiting that the king required, and there is none other than that can show it before the king, except the gods, whom dwelling is not with flesh. Capital, that is not capital G, common G, gods, idols, dumb idols. For this cause the king was angry and very furious, and commanded to destroy all the wise men of Babylon. And the decree went forth that the wise men should be slain. And they sought Daniel and his fellows to be slain. Then Daniel answered with counsel and wisdom to Arioch, the captain of the king guard, which was gone forth to slay the wise men of Babylon. He answered and he said to Arioch, the king's captain, What is the decree so hasty from the king? Then Arioch made the thing known to Daniel. Then Daniel went in, hallelujah, and desire of the king that he would give him time, that he would show the king the interpretation. Then Daniel went to his house and made the thing known to Hananiah, Mishael, hallelujah, and Azariah, his companions, that they would desire mercies of the God of heaven concerning this secret. Daniel and his fellow should not perish, but the rest, the wise men of Babylon. With the wise men of Babylon. Then was the secret revealed unto Daniel in a night vision. Then Daniel blessed the God of heaven. Daniel answered and said, blessed be the name of God forever and forever. Amen. For wisdom and might are his. And he changed the times and the season. He removed things and set up kings. He giveth wisdom unto the wise and knowledge to them that know understanding. He revealeth the deep and secret of things. He knows and knoweth what is in the darkness, and the light dwelleth with him. I thank thee and praise thee, O thou God of my fathers, who hath given me wisdom and might. Hallelujah. And has made known unto me what we desire to thee. For thou hast now made known unto us the king's matter. Therefore Daniel went into Antioch, whom the king had ordained to destroy the wise men of Babylon. He went and said thus unto him, destroy not the wise men of Babylon. Bring me in before the king, and I will show unto the king the interpretation. And Arioch brought in Daniel before the king in haste, and said thus unto him, I have found a man of the captives. Notice that the captives of Judah, that will make known unto the king the interpretation. King answered and said to Daniel, whose name was Belteshazzar. Then changed his name Belteshazzar, because Bel was one of the Babylonian god. Bel, so then gave him name whom Bel favor. Amen. Favor. And also they changed the three other Hebrew boys' name to Meshach, Shem, and Abednego. The king, amen, hallelujah, art thou able to know, or to make known unto me the dream which I have seen, and the interpretation thereof? Daniel answered in the presence of the king and said, the secret which the king had demanded cannot the wise men, the astrologers, the magician, and the soothsayers show unto the king? But there is a God in heaven that revealeth secret and make it known to the king Nebuchadnezzar what shall be in the latter days. Thy dream and the vision of thy head upon thy bed are these. As for thee, O king, thy thoughts came in thy mind upon thy bed, what should come to pass hereafter. And he that revealeth secret make it known to thee what shall come to pass. But as for me, this secret is not revealed to me for any wisdom that I have more than any living, but for their sake that shall make known the interpretation to the king, and that thou mightest know the thoughts of their heart. O king, sawest, behold, a great image. This great image, whose brightness was excellent, stood before thee, and the form thereof was terrible. The image head was of fine gold, his breast is and his arms of silver, his belly and his thighs of brass, his leg of iron, his feet part iron and part clay. Thou sawest still that a stone was cut out without hands, which smoothed the image upon his feet, that were of iron and clay, and break them to pieces. Then was the iron, the clay, the brass, the silver, and the gold broken to pieces together, and became like the chaff of the summer threshing floor. And the wind carried them away, and no place was found for them. And the stone that smote the image became a great mountain and filled the whole earth. I'm going to just touch a little bit of the interpretation, and then I'm going to teach on the interpretation. This is the dream, and we will tell the interpretation thereof. The king. Thou king art the kings of kings, for God of heaven, for the God of heaven hath given thee kingdom, power, and strength, and glory. And wherefore the children of men dwell, the beasts of the field, and the fowl of the heavens hath thee given into thine hand, and had made thee ruler over them all. Thou art the head of gold. I will give you the rest of interpretation because time is speeding away and it's a long chapter, but it is imperative that we get the scripture, because the scripture is very important. Aeon of Aeon. And Aeon of Aeon is Aeon is Greek and Aeon is Latin, age. Amen. Meaning age can refer to the eternal order or the period of time. Hallelujah. Aeon also used to mean perpetuity of eternal time. St. Mark 10:30. Amen. The aeons of the aeons, the ages of the ages. We know that God Almighty planned the ages. God in the eternal past planned the ages. And some people are not privileged to have heard such teaching. God in the eternal past. Because our God, the creator of heaven and earth, amen, he was in the third heaven when he planned the eternal past and the presence. Amen. Hallelujah. This present age was planned by God. Amen. Just can't tell you when. But God in the eternal past, that's a very long time, planned the ages. Amen. And we know there are three ages in time. The antediluvian age before the flood. This present age, Galatians 1 verse 4, St. Matthew 13, 29, 2 Timothy 4 verse 10, St. Matthew 24 verse 3. The present age, Paul speak of the present age. And then the age to come. And the age to come is the fullness of time. And I will deal with that. Because the fullness of time, I'm not jumping the gun here. Sorry for the word gun. But you can see in this chapter, amen, the time that God allotted unto man. I know there are many scholars of eschatology. They claim that the creation theory, you know, is there's a gap between verse 1 and verse 2. I leave every time and every fulfillment to God. I can't read the man of God, but I can say this, that God will reveal things unto mankind that is hearing from him. Mankind that is filled with the anointing of God and converse with him. Communicate with him in prayer. God will reveal things unto men whom are committed and devoted to him and whom is on the line, the clear channel between him, God, and those whom will listen to him. So we know that there are seven dispensations. And not only seven dispensations, you have seven covenants. But I will be dealing with the seven dispensations. The first one was the dispensation of innocent during Adam's time. Then conscience, because after Adam fell, then you have the dispensation of conscience. Man lived with their conscience. Innocent was destroyed because Adam sinned. Then we have conscience, dispensation of conscience. Mankind did what they want because their conscience tells them that this is right, this is wrong. Then after conscience, we know human government. And then after human government, we know promise. I don't have time to go and touch every one of them. But coming down from promise, you know, we have law. The law, God's law was given unto Moses. Then after law, we have grace. And we know for sure that grace is real because grace, amen, is to Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. For the law was given by Moses, but grace and truth came by Jesus. Hallelujah. And that is St. John 1 verse 17. But verse 16 says, amen, the light was made, amen, the earth, which is Jesus Christ. And of his fullness have all we received grace for grace. So we are in the dispensation of grace. But let us rewind and go back to Nebuchadnezzar and his dreams. Hallelujah. The ages and dispensation that I'm talking about, we know there are six dispensations until this time here, this present age, dispensation of grace. So God Almighty planned the ages. You can read Psalms 90. Let me just read Psalms 90. Verse 1 says, Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations. God Almighty ruled the time. Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever thou had formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. So the psalmist, which is Moses, whom Moses communicated with God, it is said that God walked, amen, and touched Moses in the cleft of the rock. And the scripture began to say, well, face to face, God Almighty, look at Moses. But nobody see God and live. I think that's a figure of speech because of the presence of God upon Moses when he left the cleft of the rock and went back down. Physically, I don't believe Moses did see God. Spiritually, yes, and God spoke to him many times. So Moses said, in all thy generations, hallelujah, God is our dwelling place. Before the mountains were brought forth, that is God in the eternal past, he planned the ages. Before the earth and the world was formed, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. You cannot take nothing from God. God is infallible, cannot be changed, infinite. God, infallible God. God is righteous. And sometimes mankind want to change the righteousness of God to please themselves. But God Almighty is still righteous all from creation, because God don't deal with time. Amen. God deal with time with man. To him. Amen. Hallelujah, Jesus. Man was created by God and is no creature of time, but created to live eternally. And thus man thinks in terms of time, namely past, present, and future. Time is relative to man, but not to God. God doesn't deal with time. 1,000 years, 1,000 years is just like a day to God. That is biblical too, in the same Psalms 90 that Moses wrote. Hallelujah. Moses was just praising God, extolling God for whom God is. He is eternal, hallelujah, with no beginning of our ending. What man turns past and future is just as vivid, amen, hallelujah, to God presently as if transpiring now. But for us to understand, God Almighty, amen, expresses himself to us in terms relative, amen, to our present, amen, time. Come on, amen, concerning, hallelujah, present time. So we know that God Almighty is from the beginning, before the beginning, when he created this earth. He formed this earth. Amen. He created this earth and called things into being. He formed man. I know sometimes we use the word, and God created man. God formed man, formed Eve. Because when you create something out of nothing. But notice God used the earth. That's why Adam means, amen, rain. He used the earth and he formed man and he knelt and he breathed into Adam's nostrils. So Adam was formed. Creation, you call it out of nothing. When you create something, you create something out of nothing. But that is high theology, but I hope you're enjoying it. God bless you. Let's go into Daniel, because it is very important that we go into Daniel, because we want to know the four, amen, world powers. That's what Nebuchadnezzar saw. Four world powers. First one, the gold. And the gold was the Babylonian Empire. That was a great empire. Hallelujah. But notice this, that at that time living in Babylon, Nebuchadnezzar's second year, Daniel and his companions, there were captives from Judea living in Babylon. They were slaves in a sense. They are captives. But because it is said that Daniel and I'm going to give you the Jewish name. Daniel went to his house and made known the thing unto Hananiah, amen, Mishael, and Azariah, his companions. Those are the Jewish name. They changed to, amen, hallelujah, and I would call it Babylonian name, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. But they were captives, but it said that they were from the lineage of kings in Judah. And that's why I look into the whole thing, their characters. I got to pluralize it because of four of them were formed by their belief in Yahweh God, the El Shaddai, the Almighty God. Because our characters, wherever we were born and whatever we were taught, we tend to grow up, and our characters, our characteristics, that's the right word, maybe it should be there, are formed by the way we were taught. There were Jewish people that worshiped the true and living God. Amen. And I look into the whole thing. Why did God allow, amen, Judah to fall? Because they were sinful, but there were people whom were worshiping Yahweh God at the time. The northern kingdom of 10 Israelites, put it that way, that formed the northern kingdom. There were 12 tribes of Jacob. 10 went to the northern side and called themselves Israel, although Jacob was called Israel. And they went into captivity, and we know what happened. We don't want to go into that another teaching. So the 10 tribes went into captivity 100 plus years before the southern two tribes that formed Judah. But God Almighty Nebuchadnezzar destroyed Jerusalem. He destroyed the first temple. And he took also the temple vessels to Babylon and many captives. But Daniel was a part of the captives, also Ezekiel. But here we have a young man whom they put him among the Chaldeans, or Chaldeans, who was the Chaldeans, the wise, so-called wise men, and the magicians and the astrologers and the soothsayers. In those days, they believed they were wise, but they weren't hearing from the real creator, the true and living God. Nebuchadnezzar had the dream, and the dream left his mind. He didn't remember one thing, but that was purposely done by God. And sometimes we may question the way God moves, because all of a sudden, here they are captives, and they're in Babylon. They could have swung towards the Babylonian way of doing things, but they were devoted and committed, amen, I would call it, people who believe in Yahweh God, who practice Judaism. As Christians, no matter where we are, hallelujah, if you are born again, the true Christians, I don't want to use the fundamental Christians, because we can use it, because we believe in the fundamental interpretation of the Bible. Amen. Scripture interprets Scripture. We believe in every word of the Bible, and sometimes people cast doubt. Amen. I thank God for the King James Version, because through the King James Version, it was translated in 1611. I got saved through it, and I live by the Bible, and I communicate with my God. Amen. Because of that, because I was brought up in the English world. But one thing I can say, Daniel and his companions, they didn't let go of Yahweh God. So the dream left Nebuchadnezzar. Nebuchadnezzar called his wise men. Notice that Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego are, if you want to use the Jewish name, amen, Hananiah, amen, Mishael, and Azariah, they weren't called, amen, before Nebuchadnezzar. Because Nebuchadnezzar had his what? Chaldeans, so-called wise men. In those days, astrologers, soothsayers, my God, magicians. And when you look into it, is this that these are the people that communicate with some spirits, it seems to be. And I would say the Babylonian system in those days, amen, was formulated by some of these so-called wise men, ideologies and philosophies. But here now, Nebuchadnezzar said, I had a dream. I had dreams. That's what he said. Amen, the Bible says. And it left my mind. You must give me the dream and interpretation. If you don't do that, you're going to be slain. And he decided, because the Chaldeans questioned Nebuchadnezzar. Oh, man. They mean the subject, our subjects of the land, questioning the authority of the king. And that's what's taking place now. I'm a born-again preacher in London, England. And I'm saying this, if I have to question the Prime Minister, you know, I've sampled many politicians, MPs and councillors, and I was there with them from the 80s to the 1990s. I just pull out myself, because the deeper you go into politics, you will find that your Christianity, amen, you have compromised many things. I'm saying that, doesn't matter, but I'm saying that. But if I say I want an audience with the Prime Minister of England at this present moment, or Her Majesty, they will call me, boy, go and sit down. Who are you? But I'm a simple minister who's hearing from God. And sometimes if we as minister, Holy Ghost minister, wherever you are, in the States here, Jamaica, England, all over the Christian world, would question these men and try to guide them. I'm glad that the president of America is surrounded by Christians, born-again Christians. Hallelujah, Jesus. So here now, they went in for the king. They could not interpret, amen, or could not give the king, amen, the dream that he had, because the dream left the king's mind. And that was God Almighty done it for a purpose, to bring his mighty power into action, to tell what's going to come. Amen. Exotology. Amen. And the word exotology means a branch of theology that, amen, talk of the concern of God time. Amen. Come on. Amen. We praise the Lord. A branch of theology. Amen. Concern with the end of the world. Yes. With the end of the world. But they could not tell him, I'm the king, Nebuchadnezzar, the dream, not interpret it. But somehow, it reached the ear of Daniel, because the king decreed that I'm going to kill him. Start killing him, captain. You must go around, I'm paraphrasing, go around now. I commanded you, I have given you the position, Mr. Captain, to kill all these wise men. Wipe them out, because they're no use. And you still have it today. Many people are hearing, amen, from so-called wise men, so-called advisors that don't have the answer. Just like what's taking place in this country right now. We have so many advisors and consultants, and they still cannot come up with, amen, I would call it the vaccine for this terrible virus. Every day, the news is bombarded. The social media, the internet, bombarded. I've got so many different things concerning the coronavirus, the COVID-19. Some chemical, full of jokes. Some are serious, and you're hearing this, that, and that now concerning what can cure, what can help you. Amen. This morning I got a few. Amen. Salt, godly truth. Amen. Lemon, put in hot water. All these things are good things for the body. We are using them for years. Amen. But Daniel heard. Daniel said, all right, Mr. Captain, cool it. Let me use a Jamaican terminology. Cool it, man. Go at ease. Amen. In Jamaica, there is a man cool. Amen. Go at ease at this present moment. Let me consult my God. So Daniel went and told the rest of the three Hebrew boys there, because there were many Hebrews living there as captives at that time. Trust me, there were many. But these were the selected four that were a part of the so-called wise men of Babylon. They were placed. You can read chapter 1 of Daniel and see they refused to eat the king's meat and they had vegetable. And they were stronger and more fairer than all the Babylonians, amen, so-called, amen, men who were sacrificing things to idol and eat it like swine and you name it, they had vegetable. Isn't that wonderful? Our God is able, amen, to sustain our strength. Hallelujah, Jesus. Ask God to vaccine you with the Holy Spirit to keep away, amen, the virus in the mighty name of Jesus. The last video on Sunday, I said the Israelites were covered by the blood and the lintel and the doorposts. Amen. We are covered. Praise the Lord. Now, let me step it up and go a little bit further. Now, the thing is that Daniel consulted his companions, three of them that were there, because if he couldn't interpret it, he would have died. They would have died with the so-called wise men, the Chaldeans and all these so-called wise men. And Daniel consulted them. And guess what? They went in and they talked to God. Verse 17, and Daniel went to his house and made the thing known unto Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah, his companions, that they would desire the mercies of God of heaven, hallelujah, concerning this secret, that Daniel and his fellows should not perish with the rest of the wise men of Babylon. He seek God. He know, that Daniel knew that the only interpretation that he's going to get a dream itself is from Yahweh God. Amen. The omniscient God. Amen. Amen. The all-wise God. Praise the Lord. Amen. God whom he reveals secret unto men. God whom planned the ages, because all these things, amen, were planned by God from God in the eternal past. Amen. Amen. He formed and he framed the worlds. Amen. Come on. Amen. Hallelujah. Hebrew 1, amen, and verse 3. Hebrew 11 and verse 3. Hebrew 1, amen, I can read Hebrew 1 and verse 1 to 2 to 3. Amen. Praise the Lord. He formed and he framed the worlds. Amen. He, God, who understand the future. He planned the future. He planned your destiny. He knows all about you. Amen. Whatever you are going through at this present moment, keep your cool and just pray to him. Continue praying to God and draw closer to God. Whatever should come, amen, God will, amen, allow things to work out, amen, on the behalf of the Christians. So he consulted them collectively. Notice that amen, collective, amen, movement that he made. He could have gone in a selfish way like some pastors and some ministers and some Christians and said, I know it all. I am the leader here. Sorry for the dramatization, amen. Let me say it in a nicer way. Some so-called Christians, they're in a competition. They think that only them alone should consult God and hear from God. I'm glad that I use everybody in my church. Last Sunday should be ladies, amen, Sunday. Amen. The young lady that was appointed to preach, amen, you will hear the message another time. But the point I'm trying to say, he consulted his companions that were there too, because if he did not get the interpretation of the dream from God, all of them would be in the same boat. But not even that. He said, come and let us pray together. They prayed together. And Daniel got the message immediately from God. Amen. Daniel extolled God. He praised God in verse 21. Amen. Verse 20. No. Daniel said in verse 19, then was the secret revealed unto Daniel in a night vision. Then Daniel blessed the Lord God of heaven. So Daniel went and he slept, and God revealed the same thing. God gave Daniel the same dream that he gave Nebuchadnezzar. Isn't that wonderful? Amen. That is not a coincidence. God gave Daniel the same dream, because that is a revelation. Dream and interpretation is classed as prophecy. Amen. When I was in prophecy class, we have learned all these things. Prediction. Amen. Dreams and interpretation. Straight prophecy. Amen. And sometimes you hear all 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 prophecies in one church. Amen. I'm going to say in one church service, Paul said, let the prophet prophesy. Amen. No more than 3, and let others judge. So sometimes when you hear some of these prophecies going on, you can judge it if you have the place to judge it. Because the Bible said, let the prophet prophesy and let others judge in Corinthians. Now I'm looking to the whole thing now. Daniel had the same dream like Nebuchadnezzar. That's why it was so real and so vivid to Daniel. So Daniel can go and tell Nebuchadnezzar. Daniel, amen, bless God first. Because sometimes we get a revelation from God. Instead of provide and bless God and give God the glory, we take it and believe it should is our revelation. I should be lifted up. I should be elevated and high. And some people, they have more prophecies in their lives and more things. They have heard so many things from God. The pastor, the bishop, never heard. And I'm wondering sometimes, that's why when they come to me, if they come to me, thank God, my church, amen, tend to listen and listen to the voice of God. I will say, hold on, take it easy. This is the interpretation. And you don't really go and, you know. But then I have some wonderful people in London. Amen. Very passive and self-effacing people. Amen. Praise the Lord. Then don't exalt themselves. Amen. But one thing, Daniel, he praised God. And then was the secret revealed. And Daniel answered and said, blessed be the name of God forever and ever, for wisdom and might are his. And he changed the times. Yes, God changed the times. Amen. Come on, somebody. Amen. Not in church, but I feel the anointing of God. He changed the times. Amen. Hallelujah. And the season. And remove kings. Yes. And that's why you see some so-called politicians believe they are rooted and grounded forever in politics. God, when God ready, God will change things. Amen. I heard some things. Amen. Somebody sent me a video. Amen. And I cannot verify it because I don't know how true it is. Amen. That Denmark is saying that you have to take the vaccine from the 12th to the 7th of March this month here. And if you don't take it, you won't be able to buy and sell, blah, blah, blah. And this, that, and that. And you're gonna for a duration until next year, March 21st of March next year. I look into that. If that is true, and they're going to give a vaccine, and if you don't take the vaccine, you won't be able to buy and sell or trade or whatever. The person says is a sign of the mark of the beast. Notice this. We supposed to have came out of Europe, Britain, 3 years ago. 3 years ago. And our politicians, let me say our politicians, because I live in London, amen, for 38 years. They want them pander and them quarrel and them this for 3 years, fighting. But thank God we are out of Europe. Because Europe is Europe. Although Britain is a part of Europe, but it's an island off the shore of Europe. Our philosophy, our theology is different than the European theology. Our philosophy is different, whether you like it or not. Amen. Our Christianity is also different. And somebody may be saying, well, I believe in pluralism and I believe the established church who started that. Good for them. I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. And my church foundation started in the first century AD. Pentecostal, we believe in the Pentecostal movement. Come on, somebody, praise God. But notice 3 years ago. So if that is a stepping stone for what's going to come in Europe, because they follow each other over there, ain't it? Although Denmark is not fully a part of the European Union, but they trade and they mingle together, but we are out of Europe. But let's go back to the dream. Now, amen, I'm trying to push it now, amen? Because we're moving, amen, with time. Now, if you listen right here and now, and this is beautiful, amen, God Almighty gave Daniel interpretation. Daniel blessed the Lord. He praised the Lord before he went in to see the king. He said to the captain, amen, that was given the decree to kill all wise men because they couldn't give the dream night interpretation. I've got the interpretation. I've got the dream. Take me to the king. Daniel went into the king. And when he went to the king, he said to the king, amen, the knowledge is made known by God. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Amen. As for thee, O king, thy thought, verse 29, came into thy mind upon thy bed, what should come to pass hereafter. And he that revealeth secret, make it known to thee what shall come to pass. That is God. Who that revealeth secret? God Almighty will reveal secret. Even the vaccine of this thing here, God gonna reveal it. And I have a feeling he may reveal it to the Jewish people because God Almighty, amen, bless Abraham. And he said in Genesis 12 and verse 2, I will bless them that bless thee and curse them that curse thee. I know many nations curse Israel, but Israel is still blessed by Yahweh God, the El Shaddai, the Almighty God. And God will reveal, amen, the secret of this virus, because majority of the scientists of the world coming down through the centuries, amen, were Jewish people and still Jewish people. I can say it with assurance, Israel, I believe, I've got news from Israel, amen, almost every day, that Israel will, amen, find, amen, the secret of this virus and the vaccine. And Nebuchadnezzar got a dream. Daniel said, you, amen, you saw a big image, a colossal image, big. I'm using some words, amen, I think you know what I'm saying. Big image, the head of gold. Amen, Nebuchadnezzar, that is your kingdom. God gave you the authority, amen, to rule, amen, to have great power and strength, amen, to rule over the children of men that dwell, the beasts and the fields. Babylon was a great kingdom. It is said that the Western commercialism started in Babylon. So Nebuchadnezzar, he built Babylon. It was a great power. He conquered many countries. Amen. But the Jewish people did go back, amen, to Jerusalem after the 70 years that was prophesied by Jeremiah. Jeremiah said they were going to be taken into captivity for 70 years. Cyrus came on the scene, and Cyrus was a different, amen, I would call it, nation, from a different nation. I'm going to go there now. And then he went on and said, hallelujah, amen, the Colossus, then you have the breastplate, the head, which is Nebuchadnezzar, great power. Nebuchadnezzar, he felt good because he getting the dream and the interpretation. And he ruled. And one time, Nebuchadnezzar even lift up himself. And guess what? He's still in that book of Daniel, you can read too. Amen. And God Almighty put him out, amen, out to grass, out of his nice palace, the hanging garden he made. God put him out and said, go and eat grass like an animal 7 years. And Nebuchadnezzar, guess what? Nebuchadnezzar came back, and after 7 years when he was subjected and subdued, amen, and he praised God, he extolled God, amen, and he said, amen, hallelujah, nobody shouldn't worship no other God but Yahweh God, Daniel God, amen. But he came back because he lift up himself and said, this is Babylon I built, and you know, feel good himself. And sometimes we as Christians, we can feel good ourselves, we have accomplished a lot of things. Amen. Amen. Be warned, my people and everybody. God can make people a base. Amen. They that lift up themselves, God will make a base. Pride, lift up in pride, and amen, a self-glorification. Amen. Self-centric. Yeah, I'm using some word today. God bless you. Amen. I. The pronoun, never going to say I. So God Almighty put him out for 7 years. It is said that his fingernail become like evil claws. Just imagine. But he came back and he finishes his term as the king, the head. After the head now, we have the Medo-Persian. Right? Because after the Nebuchadnezzar died, amen, another king by the name of Belshazzar. Amen. Not Belshazzar. Daniel, they changed the Daniel name to Belshazzar. amen, whom Bel favored, because Bel wasn't one of their gods, amen, but Belshazzar. And he said, I'm Nebuchadnezzar, amen, grandson, but he's not. It's a different, I don't have time to go into that now. But he was reigning after Nebuchadnezzar in Babylon. Amen, because I would have to give you the history, and that's going to take a long time. But amen, guess what? The time and the season got changed. Amen. The Medo-Persian army dammed up the river Euphrates and the river Euphrates and went over there, while Belshazzar, amen, having a party. And guess what he was using? He was using, amen, the holy vessel that were consecrated in Jerusalem temple for the purpose of God. And that's what I'm trying to say. If anybody touch God anointed anywhere, I don't care, amen, anywhere in this world, if you're anointed and somebody touch you and somebody go against you, somebody try to oppress you and keep you down, God will deal with them. You have a God that is almighty. I'm using the word El Shaddai many times. You have a God that is almighty. The man took, amen, the golden vessel and the vessel that were consecrated in Jerusalem, because they took them. And guess what? On the night of the party with his all princes and friends, amen, a word came up. And who you think interpreted the word? Who do you think interpreted the word? Daniel again. Amen. Interpretation. He was getting on in the age. Daniel said, your phone wanted. Amen. The balance in those days, the old scale. You have to put one and weight over here and one weight over here, whatever the weight is. You know, it's whether a pound or 2 pounds. They have what, kilo and kilogram now and whatever. So he said, your phone wanted. The meaning was like that. Dilapidated scale. And then the time up, because you trouble, amen, God's people, a heritage, the holy heritage of Israel, of Judah, sorry, amen, Judah, amen, the holy anointed vessels, you shouldn't have touched them. And the Medo-Persian, amen, kingdom started, amen, hallelujah, the breastplate, amen, amen, come on, arms of silver, and his belly and tire of brass, amen. Now after the breastplate of silver, amen, we know that it reached to the brass time. Brass is very strong, you know, and that kingdom is, you know, the Grecian kingdom, amen. Alexander the Great, he went move throughout the Middle East. He reached as far as India, it is said, and guess what happened? He had a bad fever, and then he had to return, and he died at the age of 32. So he went all the way from Greece. He conquered the known world. So we had the media.